This demonstration shows how members of a documentation team collaborate using Oxygen XML and Syncro SVN client. For simplicity's sake, our authoring team is composed of 3 members, but the principle can be scaled up for a larger team. The setup is composed of an SVN repository where the documentation project is stored, Oxygen XML author or Oxygen XML editor for editing the documentation content, and Syncro SVN client, a Subversion client application capable of managing a collaborative work style. The 3 authors working on the project are John, the subject matter expert who will input raw documentation, Tom, the technical writer who refines the documentation content and puts everything together to comply with the data style guide, and Emily, who does the proofreading and final editing of the documentation. Tom is in charge of writing the documentation for a mobile phone line of products. He already wrote some of the content and organized the documentation in an Oxygen XML project which contains data topics, tasks and concepts organized in the data map, images referred in the documentation, and settings like format and indent sizes, custom transformation scenarios, custom profiling condition attributes and sets. Oxygen automatically saves all these settings at project level to allow sharing them with the other members of the documentation team. The data topics are organized in a data map and covers the basic description and usage of the mobile phone models. Now Tom will share the documentation project with his team. He starts Syncro SVN client from the Tools menu. He configures a repository location to a known server. Then he browses the repository to the folder where he wants to store the project. Then he shares the project. After adding the project to the remote repository, Syncro SVN client automatically switches to the working copy view. Now Tom copies the repository URL and shares it with the other members of the team. Now John is invited to contribute to the mobile phone documentation project. He uses the URL information to configure the repository location in his copy of Syncro SVN client. Then he browses the remote repository and checks out locally the documentation project. Now he opens the Oxygen project file to allow Oxygen to load all the documentation project's resources and associated settings. His expertise covers the technical aspects of miniature cameras found in today's mobile phones. He just creates a new topic file from the Oxygen new file wizard, changes the topic's name, and then inputs raw technical information about 2 phone cameras. He's not a data expert, hence, he is not focused on creating a topic which conforms with the data style guide. This is Tom's job, who will further refine the topic content later on. Then he saves the topic and switches to Syncro SVN client to commit the newly created topic. In the working copy view, under the Modify tab, the newly created file appears as unversioned, so John invokes the commit action from the file's contextual menu. He inputs a message and then hits the commit button. Back to Tom, he just checks the documentation repository to see if there are any updates. Syncro SVN client reports that John added a new file today. Tom updates his working copy with the new file and then opens it in Oxygen XML. Tom uses the information John provided and starts refining the topic, then inserts a table and fills it with the camera specifications. Then adds images with the two mobile phone models. Now he decides to profile the content. One of the columns holds information about the X1000 model, while the second one holds information about the X2000 model. In the same way, Tom profiles the two images. Then he performs a quick check to see how the profile documentation looks like when he uses a specific profiling condition set. Now he realizes that the specification table lacks information about the camera frame per second rating. He inserts a comment in the topic, asking John to add the required information. Then he saves the topic and adds it into the data map. Now he saves the data map too and switches to Syncro SVN client. He synchronizes his working copy with the remote repository. Syncro SVN client reports that two of the resources are in a conflict state because in the meantime, the other member of his team, Emily, committed her work to the repository. Both Emily and Tom modified two of the files in the same time, hence the conflictual state reported by Syncro SVN client. Now Tom needs to solve the conflicts before being able to commit his modifications. Tom starts with the first file, which is specs.data. After double-clicking it, the two versions of the file are open side-by-side in the diff mode. The first difference is a true conflict. Emily added a more meaningful title, and Tom accepts this change. You can see Tom's changes highlighted in light gray. Tom accepts the incoming change from the bottom of the file, then he saves his revision of the file. Now that he incorporated Emily's modification, he marks the file as merged. Note that SVN client has now changed the status of the resource as outgoing. Now he takes care of the second file reported as conflict. In the diff view, he sees that this is actually a false conflicting state. Both Tom and Emily inserted topics in the data map structure, but they do not conflict with each other. Tom updates the file, and Syncro SVN client merges the two revisions. Now we can see that diff view reports only outgoing changes in the data map. Tom updates his working copy with Emily's new topic and commits his changes. Back to John. He updates his working copy and switches to Oxygen. He sees Tom's comment and inserts the required information. Then he removes the comment and saves the file. Then he switches to Syncro SVN client and commits his modifications. Now, Tom synchronizes his working copy. And starts reviewing the topic. One by one, he accepts the changes made by his co-workers. He is happy with the content, and he decides to commit the final form of the topic. Now Emily, our proofreader, has already updated her working copy and reviewed the content of the project. She switches to the History tab to see how the project evolved over time. Here, the following information is available: revision date, the number of files modified at each revision, author name, and a short commit message. She is happy with the current form of the project, and she decides to mark or tag this release version of the documentation. She uses the branch tag action from the contextual menu. She browses the repository structure to set the tag's destination folder. Then, she chooses a meaningful name and commit message of this documentation snapshot. Now the tag is stored in the repository. This was the last step of a documentation workflow using OxygenXML and Syncro SVN client. We've seen how members of a documentation team used OxygenXML to edit, profile, and review documentation, and Syncro SVN client to manage all changes made to the project. And this concludes our demonstration. Thanks for watching.